It's so frustrating to hear the anti-vaccination crowd bleed on about things they know nothing about. Like the creationists and the moon hoaxers, they think they're doing science, but somehow they just haven't cottoned on to the significance of the fact that people who know how to do real science keep coming to different conclusions than them. It must be because it's an evil capitalist conspiracy to make us all sick so they can profit off of us. What's ironic is that this movement, born out of extremist socialism and the New Age alt-med natural and organic philosophy, has, incredibly enough, made significant inroads in the libertarian movement over the past few years. They do this, of course, by butchering both the science and libertarian philosophy. Specifically, they claim that the scientific concept of herd immunity is collectivist. In this video, I will show, using nothing but logic and simple mathematics, that this claim is dangerously ridiculous. We see these kinds of things on anti-science woo pages such as Natural Health Strategies. Consider this article of theirs, Historical Facts Exposing the Dangers and Ineffectiveness of Vaccines. Here, they point to specific places and times, England in the early 1870s, Germany in 1940-45, USA in 60, Ghana in 67, etc., to try and make it look as if it's the vaccines themselves that are causing the diseases. They're attempting to show that, since a greater proportion of the infected population had been vaccinated, this somehow means the vaccines are the cause. Forgiving the fact that this is a baseless correlation causation fallacy, it betrays the fact that they don't even understand the basics of how diseases and vaccines work. I've set up a computer simulation that anyone can try in their web browser. The link is in the video description, and the source code for the program can be viewed simply by viewing the page source. This is a 40 by 10 grid of asterisks, each one of which represents a person. So we have 400 people in this simulation. They are green if they've been vaccinated against a certain pathogen, and red if they haven't. If they're blue, then you need to turn on JavaScript. By clicking the mouse, any one of them can be infected, whether they've been vaccinated or not. They then pass on the infection to their neighbors. If a particular neighbor has not been vaccinated, then he has a 90% chance of being infected. If he's been vaccinated, this drops to 10%. No vaccine works 100% of the time, but this reduction should be most effective. Let's try this on a completely unvaccinated population. We set the vaccine coverage on the left and the right to zero. You'll see why I divided them out in left and right later. Now we just click on any member of the population to infect him and watch the disease spread. The disease has now killed off everybody, every single member of the population. That's no good. We need a vaccine. So let's say that we introduce our vaccine and give it to 10% of the population. We'll distribute this 10% at random across the population by changing both values to 0.1. Now let's infect them again. Oh dear. It looks like we've killed them all off again. Running this multiple times, we see that we can sometimes get a lone survivor or two here and there among the vaccinated population, but for the most part, it kills off everyone, vaccinated and non-vaccinated alike. So, what, that means that the anti-vaxxers are right? It must be a global scientific conspiracy for the greedy, evil capitalist doctors and pharmaceutical companies so they can make tons of money off of us, right? Wrong! Think of your immune system like a prize fighter who can knock out anyone who comes into the ring with him. Now imagine him being beset by 10 people at the same time. No matter how good a fighter he is, he can easily be overwhelmed and defeated. Your immune system is the same way. What's happened is that the vaccination coverage has not yet reached the level of herd immunity. Even if we increase coverage to 50%, we still have the pathogen moving across the population, albeit with more survivors among the vaccinated. In this particular run, we have one lone unvaccinated survivor, because he was protected by a barrier of vaccinated people. This gives us a clue as to how herd immunity works. The more such barriers we have, the safer everyone is. Let's move the coverage up to 90%. Here, we can click on various members of the population to infect them, but the infection doesn't go very far. Sometimes that person is the only one infected. Other times, some of the surrounding neighbors are killed off as well. But it's nowhere near the complete devastation we've seen. So what are these anti-vaccination woos doing? They're arbitrarily looking at little clusters like the one we've made here. In this case, only 2 of the 9 people killed off were unvaccinated. Then they go,
"See? See? You're over 4 times more likely to die if you're vaccinated! It's all a conspiracy! The evil capitalists trying to kill us all!
I'm paraphrasing, of course. They probably won't be that coherent, but the basic point is the same. Most of the people who have been killed were vaccinated. This is true, they were, but here's the thing. That doesn't matter the first little bit. What matters is all of the people who weren't killed. Remember that without vaccines, this same simulation resulted in the death of every single member of the population. But here, with herd immunity, even if we pop in a second infection, it doesn't go anywhere. We can clearly see that this claim of more vaccinated people dying is a complete red herring. The vaccines themselves are the reason that every other member of the population, vaccinated or not, didn't get the disease. Vaccination not only protects the vaccinated, but the unvaccinated, whether they're people who are allergic to the vaccine, people with an autoimmune disorder, babies too young to be able to be vaccinated, or anti-vaccination idiots. This is not collectivism. Collectivism is a political philosophy. This is just simple math. In fact, using this simple equation, we can see that in this simulation, since any person can infect 8 others, ignoring those along the edge, we need 87.5% of the population to be vaccinated to achieve full herd immunity. What the anti-vaxxers at Natural Health Strategies and other places are doing is called the sharpshooter fallacy. This is where you fire an arrow at the side of a barn and paint a target around whatever you hit. What made them choose, for example, Germany in 1940 to 45? What happened in 45 to 50, or any 5-year period after that? Now that you've seen how this really works, you can debunk this garbage without having to look up a thing. For example,
in 1977, Dr. Jonas Salk, who developed the first polio vaccine, testified along with other scientists that mass inoculation against polio was the cause of most polio cases throughout the USA since 1961.
You don't need to look up the source to see this is bogus. Now that you've seen how this works, you can see that this is clearly meaningless unless you know how many cases of polio we're talking about, and how it compares to the number of cases prior to the vaccine. They do no such comparison. I wonder why. Could it be the number of cases is so small it will be dwarfed by the number of infections that would occur if there were no vaccine? They also ignore the fact that 50 years of technological improvements have virtually eliminated the possibility of being infected from a vaccine. Or what about this one, where
more than half of the children who contracted measles had been adequately vaccinated?
Recognize the sharpshooter fallacy there? We can use our simulation to show that we can actually expect it to be more than half, while still protecting people against a widespread epidemic. It's these very same anti-vaccination nutcases that threaten everyone else. Looking at our third pathogen that hits our vaccinated population, you can see that this random cluster of unvaccinated people causes the pathogen to spread much farther than it otherwise would have. To verify this, and to show the very real harm that comes from this anti-vaccination nonsense, let's use these different settings for left and right. Let's say that the left-hand population is the sensible one, and so they vaccinated the 90% rate, whereas the right-hand population has decided to listen to the anti-vaccination idiots and only vaccinated 10%. What happens? Let's watch. Was there ever any doubt? The people on the anti-vaccination side, even the ones who were vaccinated, died off. Except for this one lone, very lucky survivor. There was a tiny bit of encroachment into the 90% region, but herd immunity stopped it in its tracks. How can there be any question? And which side do you want to live on? The conclusion from this simulation matches exactly what scientists have found. You're protected from infection in a crowd of vaccinated people, even if you yourself are unvaccinated. But if you're in a crowd that hasn't been vaccinated, you're in severe danger, no matter how many vaccines you've had. So you can believe people who spout glib platitudes, who provide fallacious reasoning and cherry-picked data, and who aren't even aware of the basics, or you can believe simple logic and mathematics, and it only leads to one conclusion. vaccinate yourself and your children. And if you live around a bunch of anti-vaxxers, move!